And the discoveries in the fossil record were just beginning. And as the paleontologists continue to dig, as we're going to see in this next clip, what they found next was astonishing. I want you to watch.
In the summer of 1910, Walcott found a fossiliferous band in the ridge. After blasting a quarry, the geologist and his family unearthed thousands of exquisitely preserved specimens from soft-bodied animals previously unknown to science. He called the site the Burgess Shale.
There in Burgess Shale, especially the lower level, which Walcott first exploited, the preservation is miraculous, it's astonishing. We find trilobites, of course, but we find many, many other sorts of arthropods, almost none of which are ever found in a typical Cambrian assemblage. So we can treat them effectively as being soft-bodied. They have almost no chance of being fossilized in normal circumstances.
Geologists believe that the animals of the Burgess Shale were buried quickly and alive by an avalanche of sediment that created an airtight tomb and prevented the decay of soft body parts like eyes, legs, and internal organs.
Now, in the animal Morella, very often there's a sort of what we call a dark stain. And I find this very intriguing because that dark stain evidently is the body contents are oozing out. So in other words, the animal is beginning to decay and then something stops it.
The Burgess Shale was once part of a massive reef in the Pacific Ocean, a haven for a menagerie of life that thrived at the edge of what is now the North American continent. Throughout long periods of geologic upheaval, tectonic forces elevated these rocks and the fossils they bear more than 7,000 feet above sea level. Here, the basic body plans of major animal groups that still exist today, and many others now extinct, made their first appearance in the fossil record so suddenly that biologist Richard Dawkins noted, "It is as though they were just planted there without any evolutionary history."
All right, Stephen, let's tell the folks why we were showing them all this information. Why were the Burgess Shale fossils such a surprise?
Well, they were a major challenge to Darwin's theory, and they challenged Darwin's theory in two different ways. First, they challenged his picture of the history of life. As I mentioned before, Darwin had depicted the history of life as a great branching tree where the animal forms at the top of the tree represented all the forms of life that exist today. And at the very base of the tree, there was represented by a single one-celled organism, and then all the branches, connecting branches, represented how that single first organism gradually morphed and changed and became many different things over long periods of geological time. And so the first animal forms, according to Darwin, should have arisen very gradually through a series of small incremental variations and steps. But instead, they appear very abruptly. So rather than a tree-like picture of the history of life, the Cambrian fossil record documents something much more like a lawn or an orchard of separate trees that never quite connect at the base. And so you have this sudden appearance and challenges the picture of the history of life. It also challenges Darwin's idea of the mechanism by which living forms would have arisen. His idea was that natural selection, the mechanism of natural selection, would have acted on small incremental variations that would have accumulated over many, many, many generations. And therefore, that life would have arisen very, very gradually over time. The first complex animals would have arisen very gradually. But instead, what we see in the fossil record is this abrupt appearance of complexity, of complex animal forms. And this is also very contrary to Darwin's thinking about how, the mechanism of how these organisms would have arisen.